Heard a steam card, he made a mess. Pop up, guess who, bitch? Pop up, guess who, bitch? Ding dong! Must be that whip that I ordered.
Cancer, do you do anything other than stress out everyone in your life and be horny?
Do you?
Virgo, why are you so good at helping everyone else fix their life, but you can't fix your own?
I don't try R8s, I don't like those. I drive a Daytona and I tinted the windows. Can't fuck with nobody, not even my shadow. I got on A Hardy, she got on stilettos. She my best friend, yeah, we not a couple. She a rock star, she a sex symbol. The way she do that shit, she make it look simple.
I did the trend survey with my siblings. Who will never have kids?
Fuck them kids.
Who will have kids first?
Do that, baby mama.
Who's the most toxic?
You're toxic.
Who will fight anybody?
Get activated or get hurt.
Who gets in trouble the most?
Oh no.
Who's most likely to kill somebody? Who gets mad when they lose a game? Who has the worst attitude?
I don't give a fuck.
Who's the biggest simp?
Ain't gonna lie, Mr. O.U.
Who gets caught first running from the cops?
What you gonna do when they come for you?
The most challenging babies on the Zodiac. Now, I've talked about the best or the cutest, but who are the most challenging? And you'll be surprised to find out these are also often the brightest and turn out to be the smartest. But it's like they know how to push your buttons at a really young age. And they can be good, but they need a lot of attention and they can be very challenging. And I'm going to start with Scorpio. Very smart. They know instinctively what to do to get you all riled up and get a lot of attention. And they can be quiet sometimes and their eyes are looking around and they're thinking about what they're going to do next. And the next sign is Aries. Aries are very busy people, kids or babies. They like to be first at everything from a very young age. They'll push their way through. They'll find out. And you think, my God, he's just a little baby. Can't talk and laying there. But they know. They're looking all over and they're planning. And they know when to cry to get your attention and when to be good and all that. They're very smart. And we'll finish up here with Geminis. Busy, busy, busy. Very much from the minute they're born. Very smart. Going to be great salespeople. They know how to manipulate you from age zero. They know when to cry, just like the Aries do. But they're always busy looking, going, doing. And they are smart little babies. So this isn't about, these are all smart kids. They just can push your buttons and they just know how to be really challenging. So what do you think? What do you think? I'd love to hear about it. Of course I would. Carol Star Stanley, bringing astrology down to earth. And I'm here for you.
Bitch, you're my soulmate.
Most likely to. Most likely to shift realities to get railed by a fictional character. Most likely to kill someone on accident. Most likely to help the previous sign hide the body. Most likely to single-handedly overthrow the government. Most likely to change their name and live alone in the woods.
Stranger.
Most likely to swim in the nasty Hudson River for a TikTok. Most likely to get into a high-speed police chase. Most likely to have at least 30 squishmallows on their bed.
What zodiac signs are the most likely to conquer the world? Genghis Khan was a Virgo. Julius Caesar was a Cancer. Alexander the Great was also a Cancer. Attila was a Virgo. And lastly, Napoleon was a Leo.
Aquarius, Pisces, Aries, Taurus, Gemini, and Cancer women are the meanest women in the fucking zodiac sign. No cap. Y'all the meanest motherfuckers.
That the struggle was beautiful.
I don't fuck with
you, you little stupid.
You really not touching me. Just like a virgin, little bitch, can I fuck with me?
And I ain't never been pussy, bitch. You know what's up with me. Why this bitch wanna pop shit? We was just cool, now this bitch wanna act like a op bitch.
Oh, she mad, she can't stop shit.
Said that my breath stink, cause I'm spitting that hot shit.
Quit all that barking, little bitch, and come bite me. Bitches got beat, but they don't wanna fight me. Turn to my music, but swear they don't like me. You got my number, whole FaceTime.
Skype. Oi,
tem
The signs in a group chat. Hello guys, I'm a chicken. Gemini, why just why? Gemini is weird and crazy, and I love it heat. You got that right, I'm going to scare the chickens till. Guys, does anyone wanna hang him sad and bored? Yeah, same, I'm down, let's meet at the mall. I would be down if we went to Walmart. Stop talking about Walmart, it's getting fucking annoying. Okay, yeah, Walmart, I will go anywhere. Soggy, go kiss Leo's ass again, fucker. Leo hottie, come over, beautiful. I will hottie, I'm so bored and need you. Who else eats their candles? Me, I love eating them, it's just my thing. Y'all weird anyways, Virgo, let's go to the pool. I was sleeping, but okay, I will go, I guess. Chicken, chicken. Gemini, shut up. Guys, let her be. Y'all lame. F or I can't. This zodiac sign is your soulmate. This zodiac sign is your soulmate. This zodiac sign is your soulmate.
Venus is the attractive energy in your birth chart. Among other things, your Venus placement can reveal what other people find attractive about you. And I thought it would be fun to make a Venus sign series where we talk about how each Venus sign works their magic. Let's change things up and start in the middle. Venus in Libra. I'm not gonna lie, this is a placement that I am slightly jealous of. Venus is in Dominion in Libra. These Venusian qualities, such as interpersonal intelligence, aesthetic awareness, these Venusian qualities just seem to be a part of who they are. People are attracted to Venusian Librans because they are the essence of attractiveness itself, if that makes sense. An evil person with a Venus in Libra placement is dangerous. And they are dangerous because of these two words, halo effect. And no, don't be like, who, me? Yeah, you know exactly what I'm talking about, guys. Venus in Scorpio, being ruled by Pluto, the sign of Scorpio itself has this profound awareness of the deeper aspects of the human experience. And you'll find that Venusian Scorpios, they wanna know all of your ins and outs, your history, your traumas, those idiosyncrasies that you keep hidden from the world. This is how Venus and Scorpios connect, and this gives them this very magnetic quality When someone's interested in a Venus in Scorpio, it can transform into an obsession. But we sometimes forget that magnets repel just as much as they attract. Connecting with someone in such a heavy way can be disturbing to some people who aren't ready for that yet. And like, now that I think about it, if you've been speaking to a Venus in Scorpio for like a while and they just haven't gone deep with you yet, they're probably just trying to sleep with you. Or relationships just aren't a priority in their life at the moment, because that deep connection is a Venus in Scorpio's gateway to a deeper relationship. Oh my god, I was supposed to get to Venus in Sagittarius, but we're almost out of time. I'm not irritated at myself for rambling at all. Anyway, see you next time for the Venus in Sagittarius video. Bye guys.
Cause I be the baddie beat, Young Money.
It's an army.
He ain't in the choice, but he fuck.
With the Barbie, it's the president.
Monica, what they called me. Nikki the ninja.
Nikki the boss.
Nikki the have a juju.
Let's have an open conversation. Let's start a dialogue here. Because listen, I love fire signs. They're one of my favorite people. I have so many fire sign friends, but I'm getting real tired of this pattern I'm noticing of you guys loving to dish it out, but not being able to take it. Fire signs, I love you, but stop dishing it out. Stop throwing shots if you can't take it back, right? Because everyone's always like, oh, water signs are so sensitive. And yeah, we are. We are, and we know that. So we're not gonna fucking go out and start like dragging other people because we know we fucking sensitive. And if you say shit to us, we gonna cry. So what the hell we gonna do now? I want more fire signs to admit their sensitivity so the rest of us can have peace. Because the little front that y'all putting up now is not working for me. Period.
You make me a maniac, but you don't know.
Nobody's bigger than the group.
I'm the one selling the records. They coming to see me.
They coming to see the Temptations.
Ain't nobody coming to see you, Otis.
Alone.
I'm sitting here looking at Keisha like, do you love me, do you love me not?
My days are cold without you.
Damn, you hit the spot.
I've got no roots, but my home was never on the ground. I've got no roots, but my home was never on the ground. I've got no roots, I've got no roots. I've got no roots, but my home.
I just wanna fuck all night.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, 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 baby, I need to know.
White Porsche, white wrist, white horse, high bitch, high bitch, high bitch, high bitch.
I don't really got no tights, I just wanna fuck all night.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, 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 baby, I need to know.
Sights.
I just wanna fuck all night.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, 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 oh.
romantic. Talking, you don't even have to try. You're cute enough to fuck with me.
I gotta testify. Come up in the spot looking extra fly. For the day I die.
I wanna be a slave, I wanna be a master. I wanna make your heartbeat run like roller coasters. I wanna be a good boy, I wanna be a gangster. Cause you could be the beauty and I could be the monster. I love you since this morning, no, just for aesthetic. I wanna touch your body, so fucking electric. I know you're scared of me, you say that I'm too eccentric. I'm crying on my tears and that's fucking pathetic.
A white woman's Instagram. Latte foam art. Tiny pumpkins. Fuzzy comfy socks.
Doesn't cry. A princess doesn't cry.
But you don't know.
If happy ever after.